When you created the Bernie Show,
yes, Bernie Mac Show,
it was weird. It was weird because we were on tour. We were doing the Kings of, also has an anniversary.
That's so right.
The anniversary of your canceling and our 20th.
Yeah, he's gonna keep bringing that up.
We should have a party together.
That's a lot of whiskey at that party.
One of the things that happened when we were on tour was Bernie had this sense that no one would give him an opportunity.
That's right.
And it was because primarily nobody, like I remember him going and people said they couldn't understand him. And one of the ways you were pivotal is being able not to change him, but to present him in a way that worked for him. And then he took off.
Exactly. Mm. I knew that they had tried a multi-camera show with Bernie the year before. I think, what was it called? I can't remember. But it was really bad, you know. And one of the things that Bernie was so raw in the clubs, if you were a watered down version of Bernie on TV, it just wasn't going to work because people didn't want to see that. So rather than compete with that, I thought I'd show a different side of Bernie rather than try to just compete on that high energy level. Let's go inside, you know, and that's why single camera is important. There weren't many single camera shows at that time. It was just Malcolm in the middle.
Titus
actually was in front of an audience though. But it was shot in high definition, which was the only show that was shot in HD. But yeah, he shot it. If you look back, there's a laugh track there because he's in front of an audience. But Titus was a very creative show.
It
broke a lot of ground. But and I had to fight, you know, to get a lot of that at the time too, you know. But the story that we were trying to tell was more of an inner story, more about a person's journey, you know, and that sort of thing, more than big jokes, you know, and that type of thing. And I'm still proud of the pilot that we made.
How could
you know?
You not be? Mm-hmm.
You know, and even if you watch it today, it feels like a real story, like we're eavesdropping on it, you know. When
why
can I call you Uncle Bernie?
That...
No, you got to call me Uncle Daddy.
Why were you able to do something that there were a lot of writers? I mean, Bernie had a lot of deals, a lot of, you know, A-list writers.
Mm-hmm.
And at the time, you were in two, like the idea that you were able to take a cat like Bernie, who knew he was going to, people were going to find him. I just didn't know how they would get there. But you had to navigate a couple of different.
It was time. It was time, dear. I had the idea without Bernie in it based on a show. There was a show on PBS called 1900 House. And it was a show where they, people had to live as if it was 1900.
Sure.
You know, and
like
they,
now.
Yeah, exactly. And they rigged cameras in the house, and I thought this is real fascinating. And you felt like you were observing the action, and we were right at the height of reality television. It was just starting to come in. Real World had been on for years, and I wanted to do a show where it felt like we were observing this family rather than the action being pushed at us. I had just done the PJs, the show with Eddie Murphy, the animated show.
One of my all-time favorites. Loretta Devine was on the
show. And one of the things about the PJs, it was so different. I thought, man, you know, so I was kind of spoiled by having done something so different on television. I wanted to follow up, you know, keep doing something different. And When I saw Bernie and Kings and I saw what he said, that y'all afraid of me, you know what? Yeah, well, hear me, you know, saying all that stuff.
That's exactly how he sounds.
Exactly.
Were you sure you weren't playing him?
I know, exactly. But I approached Bernie about it. I pitched it to him and he loved it. He thought it was great. And when we pitched it to Fox, they pretty much bought it in the room. But there was still resistance to the form of it because the form was so different and the rhythms were different.
I've never seen anything like that.
But I knew I had to upset those rhythms. I wrote a lot of the rhythms differently in the script itself. And Ken Kwapis, who directed it, to prepare for it, we actually watched like French New Wave films and things like that because the editing style had to be different.
That's why I say you're one of the weirdest people. Like, we grew up in the same city, and I've never watched a French film ever.
Well, you should start watching.
There's some. But you do a lot. You know a lot of weird things.
A French porno, but not a French. Not the French guy.
Same thing, pretty much.